BK, we're going to talk about the Texans running back spot here in a moment. They need to drastically overhaul the running back position because it's a joke what they currently have right now for being nice. Before we do that, though.
Yes, sir.
Someone on Twitch made a great point. Did you finalize a day for you to spend the 24 hours in the Waffle House? Now that football season's come and gone, a lot of people want to know, when is the day you will be spending the 24 hours inside a Waffle House paying off your punishment?
It's a good question. Need to reach out to Waffle House and make sure all of the details are finalized before we announce an official date.
So nobody's trying to kick you out or whatever?
Yeah. Just want to make sure I can actually be there for 24 hours. And I know Waffle House doesn't close, but I don't know. Just make sure that that's okay with people, because I'll also be filming.
Yeah.
And chronicling my journey on social media.
You should just stay at one until they kick you out, and then you have to go to another one.
Waffle House to Waffle House.
Waffle House transient.
That's also a really good idea as well.
Waffle House. Waffler? No, that doesn't make any sense. Ignore that I said that.
If they throw you out of one Waffle House.
You got to do a lot to get thrown out of a Waffle House.
That's why I think if you just show up,
I've seen people cooking their own food in a Waffle House.
That's the goal. I hope at some point during the 24-hour journey that all of the cooks just walk outside and I just go behind the counter and start whipping up some eggs, some bacon, maybe some hash browns, get them all scattered, smothered, and covered.
Cooks walk outside. What are you talking about? I'm talking about you getting a second gig by the time you're out of there. It's like your last 8 hours is on
you guys
the grill.
Might never see me again after that day. I might have such a good time. I might never want to leave.
Short order BK.
I don't know. We'll work on it. I was thinking this Friday, but I forgot the rodeo kind of starts this weekend, so I'm doing some rodeo stuff. I promise it'll get done.
You're in the rodeo as well?
Not
you were
in the rodeo.
Galveston Mardi Gras parade, and now you're in the rodeo.
Not in the rodeo.
You're going to the rodeo?
It'd be fun, though. Yes.
Okay.
Attending the rodeo. We'll get it done. It'll get done the end of March for sure.
Nice.
Earlier today, the Texans made all their assistant coaches available to the local media over at NRG Stadium. And the new Texans offensive line coach, George Warhop, said that he judges the team's success on running the football based on yards per carry, also known as YPC. He said, ideally, the Texans should be around 4.2 to 4.4 yards per carry. That's what he's looking for from his running game. Now, the Texans have had the worst running game in the NFL the last 2 years. In fact, the running game they had this year was the worst in franchise history. The Texans averaged 3.4 yards per touch. That is pathetic, awful. And yes, they have bad running backs, but a lot of that, Cody, was the offensive line struggled to run block as well. Mm-hmm. If you're redoing the running game for the Texans, offensive line, running backs, how are you going about it? Is this a draft thing? Is this a free agent thing? What's the ideal approach to actually run the football better? Because if you want to evaluate Davis Mills, giving him some semblance of a running game will really help his development.
No doubt. No doubt about that. George Warhop has one of the toughest jobs on the Texans coaching staff when it comes to the season. He's got to fix that offensive line, and he has got to find a way to get that running attack going for the Texans. And he has one of the toughest jobs, because we don't know who the tackle at left tackle for this team is. We don't know if they're going to keep Charlie Heck. He's got to go through evaluate all these guys, because it's not like he coached them. They coached against them to an extent. He's been in the division the past few seasons with Jacksonville, and the Jaguars have had some decent success the past few years running the football and the yards per carry stat that Warhop seems to value as an offensive line coach. He got to fix them up front. And then they've got to get better talent at the running back position. It's fascinating to me that the running backs coach, Danny Barrett, has survived three different coaches now at this point. He was with Bill O'Brien. He got to hang around after that. He was with David Culley last year. He got to hang around after that. Now he's with Lovie Smith. The running back position has been underperforming basically since Arian Foster got hurt way back in the day. Like, since that moment, it has not been an impressive position for the Houston Texans. Lamar Miller was not as good as he was in Miami for the Texans. Alfred Blue spent a good chunk of time as the primary running back for this team. Obviously, the David Johnson debacle is something that we all lived through watching this team. They've got to upgrade the overall talent in the running back room, And then Warhop's got to figure it out on the offensive line. I don't know if it's a scheme thing. I don't know if it's just finding new players, but he's got to help them get better on the offensive line.
I don't know if that's going to happen.
So you think they're just going to suck at running the football again?
My point is, I don't know if some of these guys can be fixed.
Okay.
I think some of the offensive linemen on this team are just bad.
Yeah.
I don't know if any coach is going to come in here and correct some of the problems that some of these guys have. So for me, the most important person in turning the Texans offensive line slash run game around is Nick Caserio.
Okay.
He's got to draft offensive linemen, and he's got to hit on some of these O-line draft picks. He really does. That's why I'm perfectly comfortable with the Texans taking a tackle at three. Like, they absolutely have to get the ground game going, and that doesn't happen without an offensive line. Running backs are important. Of course, I want the Texans to draft a running back in this draft. Maybe two. I'd be okay with that, especially if they get more picks in a Watson trade. And the Steelers had a god-awful running game 2 years ago. They drafted Najee Harris in the first round last year, the best running back in last year's draft class. And this year, they were still 28th in the NFL in yards per carry. It's because their offensive line still sucks. So it's more important to take care of that offensive line and make sure you can block than to get that running back taken care of. So I don't disagree with the point about running back, but they have to completely revamp this offensive line. And we're talking about them trading their best player in Laremy Tunsil. They've got to find a way to bring in multiple dudes who can help fix this thing right away, because I don't think the dudes on this roster are good enough to create a solid running game week in and week out.
What's really frustrating for me when it comes to the offensive line is, for a very long time, it was apparent they were not well coached. Mike Devlin was their coach for a long time. They continuously underperformed. Because he's Bill O'Brien's buddy, he got to keep coming back year after year after year. And I asked Bill O'Brien one time, I said, who do you talk to in the offseason? Who do you go to assess your performance? One of the first names he mentioned was Mike Devlin. I was like, okay, well, Mike Devlin's never getting fired until Bill O'Brien gets fired. They're boys, they're buddies. And then they bring in James Campen last year. Aaron Rodgers gushes about the guy. He has a great reputation, and then he's out of here after a year.
Did he make the Instagram post last night?
He did not make the Instagram post last night. He's out of here after a year. They brought in some new faces. Those guys underperformed. Marcus Cannon was never healthy, and when he was healthy, he wasn't any good. Charlie Heck played better than him. Lane Taylor took forever to get healthy. When the time he was healthy, he wasn't any good. He didn't play a ton. That was, you know, not great by Nick Caserio and company. Taylor was in because Campen was familiar with him. Like, they got to get new face. Like, they can't just get five new offensive linemen that are all going to be starters, but, like, I'd almost want them to do that at this point. I don't want Justin Britt back. I don't think he played well at center last year. Like, it's just, it's frustrating because they have invested at different times significant capital into this offensive line. Max Sharping's a second-round pick. Titus Howard's a first-round pick. All the stuff that they gave up for Laremy Tunsil. The offensive line stinks. It stinks. Yeah.
They still need to improve at running back, though. And the draft's the best place to do it. There are guys every year that come in the second round, third round, fourth round, fifth round that end up being really good players. You look at the list of free agent running backs, by the way, it's terrible. It's awful. Melvin Gordon, who's going to be 29 this year, you want him? He was the best running back that's available as a free agent if you look at rushing yards and a combination of touchdowns. Sony Michel, you want him? Leonard Fournette going into his age 28 season, you really want him? Like, these guys break down so quickly, it makes no sense to sign anyone that's a free agent and pay them any sort of major money. So you look at the draft, and the draft always has a bunch of guys that come in and end up being really good. Kenneth Walker from Michigan State, they used a second-round pick on the guy, sign me up. Breece Hall from Iowa State, love that guy. I think he's going to be really good. A&M fans, Isaiah Spiller would look really good in a Texans uniform. James Cook from Georgia, I like him. Damian Pierce from Florida, big bruiser back, I like him. There's a lot of good running backs that are in this draft class, and if you're the Texans, you probably do want to take one or even two. You got 9 picks, and if you want to drastically overhaul your offense, you're not going to be able to fix your offensive line in 1 year, but you could find a diamond in the rough running back or two in this draft.
I really hope that Rex Burkhead's contract extension that he got last year fulfills their desire to have a veteran in the room, and the rest of it is young guys, maybe guys who have bounced around for a year or two on practice squads, hasn't gotten a real shot yet. Like, I don't not want a I do not want to hear that the Texans have amassed the most rushing yards ever when you combine all the guys' careers for the running back room, which is something that they touted last year. I don't want that anymore. I want Rex Burkhead to be the veteran.
Yep.
I want him to teach young guys that are in the room. Maybe there's some undrafted guys. They go undrafted. I'd love to use a draft pick on a running back at some point. And then, to BK's point, I'd love to use some quality, important draft picks on improving the talent and the offensive line, because the last group didn't know how to evaluate talent on the offensive line, and they blew it. Brian Gain blew it with Max Sharping. Bill O'Brien blew it with Titus Howard, moving him all around on the offensive line, not playing him at left tackle, and Bill O'Brien blew it with the investment in Laremy Tunsil. So the last crew messed it up on the offensive line, and I understand Caserio had a lot of restrictions on what he could accomplish last offseason. Well, he has far less restrictions this offseason, so he's got to accomplish something from bringing and evaluating talent on the offensive line.
Look, they have to draft a running back, but even if they do bring in a running back, that guy's not going to look good behind the offensive line the Texans have had the last 2 years. So that's more important to getting the ground game going. But I agree. I think on day two, the Texans should be in the market for a running back.
He'd look a lot better compared to Rex Burkhead, David Johnson, Philip Lindsay. Like, I've seen a lot of running backs play behind bad offensive lines. They're really good ones, can still find a way to take a loss and turn that into a couple-yard gain. You know when you have a good running back.
Just find me a guy that knows to go north and south and not east and west like Philip Lindsay did.
Like, the running backs they put out there this year was a joke. It was a joke. So they have to draft more than one, in my opinion. At least one. If you draft one in the second round, fine. That's a premium pick you're using on that position. You have to, especially when you're a team that's bereft of offensive talent. Find a guy that could catch passes out of the backfield. Maybe that's how you could help Davis Mills as well.